สวัสดีค่ะเพื่อนเพื่อนวันนี้ที่อเมริกาวันเป็นวันจันทร์นะคะเย็นวันจันทร์เวลาประมาณ4 โมงเย็นวันนี้เรามีภารกิจที่จะไปดูการแสดงของน้องจูนที่โรงเรียนเขาจัดการแสดงของนักเรียนระดับชั้นเตรียมอนุบาลกันที่ห้องสมุดในเมืองจะไม่ใช่ห้องสมุดที่โรงเรียนแต่ว่าจะเป็นห้องสมุดในเมืองซึ่งจะมีพื้นที่กว้างขวางกว่าที่โรงเรียนการแสดงจะเริ่มประมาณ6 โมงเย็นตอนนี้ก็ประมาณ4 โมงครึ่งแล้วเดี๋ยวคุณแม่น้องจูนจะจับน้องจูนอาบน้ำเปลี่ยนเสื้อผ้าแล้วก็คุณแม่เองก็จะเตรียมตัวเองให้เรียบร้อยแล้วก็จะพาน้องจูนไปทำการแสดงไปดูการแสดงมันจะเป็นเหมือนกับว่าการทดสอบพัฒนาการของเขาว่าเขาฟังพูดสื่อสารได้รู้เรื่องไหมเดี๋ยวเราตามไปดูกันว่านางจูนจะแสดงอะไรวันนี
Welcome. This is our fall literacy night. Because we don't participate in the music concerts, this is a great opportunity for us to show you all. In the afternoon, she decided to go out for a walk in the forest and collect herbs and spices, nuts and seeds. She walked so long and so far, it started to get dark. There was only a sliver of moon shining in the light. Suddenly, she stopped right in the middle of the path for 2 big shoes, and the shoes went... And the little lady said, and on she walked a little bit faster, but behind her she could hear 2 shoes go. Farther down the path she bumped into a shirt, and the shirt went, and the little lady said, and on she walked a little bit faster, but behind her she could hear 2 shoes go. One shirt go. A little ways on, the little lady bumped into a pair of pants, and the pants went. And the little lady said,
I'm not
ready,
silly pants.
And on she walked a little bit faster, but behind her she could hear 2 shoes go. One shirt go. One pair of pants go. Farther still, a little lady bumped into 2 white gloves. And a tall black hat, and the gloves went. And the hat went. And the little lady said,
I'm not a baby, hat and gloves.
And on she walked a little bit faster. But behind her, she could hear 2 shoes go. One shirt go. One pair of pants go. 2 gloves go. One hat go. By now, the little lady was walking at quite a fast pace. She was very near her cottage when she was startled by a very huge, very orange, very scary pumpkin head, and the head went... This time, the little lady did not stop to talk. She ran, and she didn't stop to catch her breath until she was safe inside her cottage with the door locked. She sat in her chair by the fire, and she rocked until she heard... Should she answer it?
Yes!
She was not afraid of...
Anything!
So she went to her door, and what do you think she saw? 2 shoes go. 1 shirt go. 1 pair of pants go. 2 gloves go. 1 hat go. 1 scary pumpkin head go. The little old lady said,
I'm not afraid of you. What do you want?
What do you want?
We want to play.
got your own books, don't you?
Yeah.
Pete sees some friends reading on a long table. It's very peaceful and quiet. How relaxing.
Can you sit down?
Can you
sit down?
The librarian takes Pete to her favorite room. There was a lot of Pete-sized chairs and tables and shelves. There are lots of books in every shape, size, and color. What do we do now, Pete asked. Now you can read a book, the librarian says. Which book should I read, asked Pete. You can read any book you like, says the librarian. Pete looks around. There are so many books. Do we have a lot of books at the library?
Yeah.
Don't we? Pete picks up a book all about airplanes and jets. He reads it and he pretends that he's a pilot. And he flies a super fast jet and goes loop-de-loops up in the sky. So he's reading a book about airplanes and he's flying, isn't he? Yeah. Then Pete finds a book about dragons, wizards, and unicorns on the cover. What's Pete going to do when he reads about that? He reads and imagines that he's a powerful wizard using his magic spells and a special wand to defend his castle against the fire-breathing dragon. See a knight and he's going to save it?
Yeah.
Next, Pete opens a book about spiders and insects. And he reads it and imagines he's a scientist studying all kinds of critters in the world. He is very still to study some creatures and very fast to study others, doesn't he?
It's called the butterfly.
Yeah, he did. Yes, he's really fast. Then Pete chooses a book with all sorts of scary monsters on the cover. It was a book of fairy tales. Pete reads it and pretends that he is in a dark, scary forest trying to outsmart the big, bad wolf. Pete puts his book back on the shelf. It was a little too scary. Think it would be scary with the big bad wolf?
Yeah.
Pete opens up a book about pyramids in Egypt, and he reads and pretends that he's an explorer on a camel across the desert and climbs to the top of the giant pyramid. He imagines all that stuff when he's reading his books, doesn't he? Next, Pete picks up a book about all sorts of robots on the cover. He reads it and imagines that he's a robot at a robot dance party. How do you think you dance at a robot dance party? Yeah! Would that be kind of fun to dance like a robot?
Yeah.
There we got some robots going. His arms and his legs make whizzing sounds when he moves. When the robot speaks, it says, beep, bop, beep. How would your robot speak? You would say, I am a robot.
You're right.
Next, Pete picks up a book about superheroes. And he reads it and makes believe he's a superhero. He flies in the city in a colorful cape, chasing bad guys and saving the day. Have you guys ever read a book about superheroes?
Yeah.
And you're a superhero? Can you fly like a superhero?
There you go.
We got superheroes all over here, don't we?
Yeah.
Are you a supergirl?
Yeah, I'm a superwoman.
You're a superwoman? Okay. Then he plots a big book about the ocean and all of its creatures. He reads it and imagines that he is a scientist in a submarine deep in the Atlantic Ocean, looking for whales and squids and sharks and octopuses. There is an octopus and jellyfish. What else would be in the ocean?
A fish. Alligators
in the ocean? Oh my goodness, you got a silly ocean. There are so many wonderful books to read in the library. Pete can do whatever he imagines with it when he reads a book. Reading is super groovy. Pete the Pat always says, I'm groovy. So reading is groovy. You can come to the library and get a book and you can read whatever you want, can't you? Yeah. And you know what? We have something for you guys. Then you can go and get some treats. Okay?
Some books.
Yeah, what?
Just so you know, I'm losing my mind. Marshall, do you want a Frank?
Say thank you.
Do you want me to help you?
Yes.
Why you take a lot? Okay, let's go. Oh, take a seat. Yeah. Right, let's go. Be careful.
She has to wear pants because Elsa does not wear pants.
Oh,
well,
see,
you are not Elsa.
We're the other way around.
Like, she's all like,
yeah. I don't know if I can get her that skirt anymore.
Marshmallow? Sit down.
I got one too.
Yes.
I got a lot of anime.
A little appetizer.
What?
This is Lisa. I know, right? Probably will be. It's a special night. It's not the battle anyway.
I'm from Omaha. Let me leave this out now. I'm going to do it.
Right.
Mom. Yeah.
Can you help?
That's Taylor.
Good
job, buddy.
Taylor, do you know my good marshmallow? I don't like the small ones.